am Sade, and today I'm going to show you how to customize your lace frontal and also how to put some natural looking baby hair on it too. I'm going to be using hair from Lockie Hair. They sent me 3 bundles of 18 inch Brazilian hair along with a 18 inch frontal that I colored a little bleach blonde in the front just to do something cute with it. And I also put some crimps in it too for styling. In developer, and I also made a wig unit out of it. So I'm going to show you how to pluck your frontal a little bit more in depth. This frontal, it came plucked, like pre-plucked, but it wasn't plucked enough for me. So I went in and I plucked it a little bit more to make it a little bit more natural looking. So you can see that this frontal, see how much that they had already pre-plucked. So I just went in behind the hairline and just plucked it some more. You want to pluck behind the hairline, and also you want to make the front of the hairline a little bit jagged and not so straight across. And you want to pluck in a motion, a vertical motion. And you want to keep plucking until you get a natural look. I'm trying to get rid of that line of demarcation, so you can see that I'm plucking that line away. So I'm just going to keep plucking until it looks natural enough for me. Also want to make sure the hair is wet while you're plucking, because the hair comes out easier when it's wet as opposed to when it's dry. So if it starts to dry up, just wet it again, because it's going to make your plucking process much easier. It's going to make your plucking process much easier. So this is the one side that I plucked. You can see it looks a little bit more natural. And I'm going to show you the other side that I didn't pluck. And you can see the difference. So I'm going to go ahead and get that line of demarcation out of there. And I'm going to go ahead and pluck the other side so it matches the side that's already plucked. Can see how it matches up with your hairline to see if you need to pluck it a little bit more or if it's perfect or leave it alone. I try not to over pluck, because once you start manipulating it and messing with the frontal, frontals are a little weak, they're very sensitive, so the hair starts to come out a little bit more easier. So I try not to over pluck to try to increase the longevity of the frontal so it lasts longer. So after you're finished plucking, this is how much hair you should have left. You might even have way more hair than that, but that's how much you would have left. So to go ahead and do these baby hairs, I'm going to comb out just the small fringe on the front. Not a whole lot. Now we're going to make these baby hairs natural. We don't want to do no thick baby hairs. We want to make these baby hairs look as natural as possible. So if I'm pulling out the hair in the front and it looks a little too thick, I'm going to take some tweezers and I'm going to pluck some hair out, because you want it to look thin and natural, like your natural edges. You don't want no big, thick swoop. So I'm going to thin it out a little bit with some tweezers. I'm gonna leave about a half inch to an inch of hair, so I'm gonna cut a lot off, so it should be a half inch to an inch left on the frontal before I put the Gotsabe gel on to lay the baby hairs down. Now, I'm demonstrating this on the mannequin head because it's easier for me. I mean, on the dome head because it's easier for me, but you want to do this while it's on your head because you're going to get a better sense of where to lay the baby hairs at, especially if you need to customize the frontal to your head sizing. So make sure you do this on your head and not while it's on the dome head. So I'm going to go ahead and take a little brush. You can use a little toothbrush, whichever. I found this little brush at the beauty supply store for $1. So I like to use a brush when I'm doing these type of baby hairs on a frontal because it works out better for me as opposed to using the comb. I love using a comb on a human head, but not on this type of hair. I prefer to use a brush because I get more precision with a brush on the frontal. So I'm going to do the same thing on the top. Leave about a half inch, in between a half inch to an inch. I'm going to put the Gotsabe gel on again and I'm going to swerve them baby hairs. And these baby hairs should lay, because you're using a Gotsabe gel, so it should lay just as long as your frontal holds up. You shouldn't have to redo the baby hair, especially if you're tying it up. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Once you're done scooping your baby hair, when it's on your head, you can spray some hairspray on it or take a blow dryer and blow dry it dry so it's definitely sticking to your head and not lifting up. So this is what you should look like. Remember, you're going to put this on your head.